Okay, everybody, well, welcome to the opening webinar. It's top of the hour where we can start. And before we do begin, usually make sure that everybody's able to see the screen properly. Looks like some of you have confirmed in other areas to let me know, especially through Skype, that you're able to. So we will continue. What I want to demonstrate here is how to configure the LSI Syslog events and what is reported to the DSS V7 event viewer. Today is January 15th, 2013. My name is Todd Maxwell, and we're going to go some other items with you on the next screen, and then we'll get done with the PowerPoint right after this and go right into the demonstration. So we're going to be connecting to the LSI RAID controller with the MegaRAID Storage Manager. We'll configure the syslog category, so I'll kind of show you some specific events that can be set up. And then we're going to see the report from the DSS V7 Event Viewer. There you're going to see some of the outputs that the DSS will be reporting from the LSI RAID controller. And of course, we always do recommend to set up the DSS V7 and V6 emails at every installation that you do. So let's go ahead and take a look at the first site I want to take you is to the knowledge base article. So here, we wrote this knowledge base article based for the controlling of the alerts sent to the DSS V7. Now in V6, it's a little different. You have to configure the LSI RAID controller for email, the events, and also the DSS for email. But here you're gonna be configuring the alerts that are being sent to DSS V7, because a lot of times you really don't need all the alerts. Sometimes it's just information. It ends up being more emails and events that are really unnecessary. Like power uptime, how long it's been uptime. I don't think you need events sent to you on a regular basis. So you might want to take some of those off. So here in this article that we wrote, basically the information is for the categories are information, critical, and fatal. So what you want to do is disable this in the MegaRAID Storage Manager and remove some of them that may not be important to you, considering the system log. What that system log then can do is save you the amount of information, overload, spams, and so you can desire them for specific or the whole groups. So let's do some of the simple things first that we need to get done. First, we want to be able to go into the DSS V7. You want to go to Setup, and you want to go to Administrator Settings. You want to make sure that your email notification is set up properly. You want to make sure that it's clicked on for send errors, and also when you first set it up to send a test message. And of course, you set up your email account, your outgoing mail server, make sure that's set right in your port, and then go ahead and hit apply right down here. And that's going to send you a test message that's going to send to your email, and you want to verify that first. Then, what we're going to show in my LSI RAID controller, by the way, you want to use the MegaRAID Storage Manager. If you're using the Intel RAID controller, make sure you use the RAID Web Console Tools, that they have there for you at the Intel's website. Here I have two volumes that I've created, so I'm going to use the LD01 as an example. But before, you could see PD4 is the status is good for this drive. And what we're going to do is we're going to go pull that drive in about a second or two, because we want to make sure our setup's up. 1 second. I got somebody who's going to help me, and just give me a second. We'll go through the MegaRAID Storage Manager. So let's go ahead and log in. And here I'm at the MegaRAID Storage Manager. By the way, I'm using this version up here, 12.08.03.03. I know there's a recent release out, but this one I've been using and it's quite stable. Here we're going to go ahead and log into our server. So the username and password is RAID. So the username is RAID, the password's RAID, it's all lowercase. And you want to select full access. And while it's loading up, what you want to do is go right into the physical devices, make sure you're seeing the proper RAID controller, you have the updated firmware, always check that right here on the right side. So I'm seeing them. There is a newer firmware. I think it's 3.223, one using one rev behind. So just to let you know that they work on most recent versions, but for this purpose, we're using these versions. So right now, I'm just going to go to Tools, Configure Alerts, and you can see some of the categories here. So if I don't want the information, I can go ahead and edit this and just take the system logs out. So that way I'm not getting all the information. So a lot of it is considered spam, it's overload, it's not important. So you can go ahead and or identify these specifically. So if I were to select, let's say, change individual events, well, as you could see, there is a plethora of types of events you can see. The critical ones, I really don't like to change the categories on that. So right now, let's just go ahead and take the basic, and we're going to do a live demonstration. We're going to leave the information and everything as it is right now. And we're going to go ahead and pull this drive. And I got somebody helping us. So he's going to let us know that he pulled it. And we have our email set up in the alerts here. So once he pulls it out, and it should take but a moment, we're going to see that the alerts are going to be coming in. So he's just confirmed. Ah, we see alerts. So he just pulled the drive. Let's go find out what happened. Now the time is 2:07 is what we're showing here. And it's today's the 15th. So you could see we have the drive was removed. So in this case, you definitely want to set up your alert system with the DSS and email. So just because you have alerts here that's coming from the DSS, you want to make sure that you're remotely getting emails from your cell phone or something to identify or let you know what's happening to identify which drive failed or what's happening with the RAID controller. So if we look, and by the way, could you put that drive back in? We'll go ahead and put that drive and see if we get another notification. So you could see that there was resets on the port and the errors that comes out on the path that's reporting from the LSI RAID controller from the MegaRAID storage manager setup that we did for the configuring alerts. So let's check our email. Here we see that the email has been sent. We see that we're going to do another send and receive because we did some tests before. And here comes the latest. So here is the same message that we received in the event viewer. So physical drive removed on port 4. So this helps identify and save you when you need to be able to be ready for events that these can be sent to your cell phone. So he just inserted that drive. Let's see if we get some more information coming back from the DSS. And we do. So here it comes. So you can see that it's pretty quick on responses for events that take place on the RAID controller. Now, if we go back to the DSS, we'll have more events here, but I wanted to show you the information. So here's where you can get just a lot of information. You may not want to see all these states. So what you probably want to do is then go back to your MegaRAID storage manager and you want to change these values. So individually you can change them or on just the information, I typically just take the system log off and leave the MSM log in there. If I want to do email for the information, that's up to your choice, but I definitely want to be able to set up email for the critical and fatal events. And possibly maybe some email events on the warning. So that might be helpful. So here you could set up your mail server. You set all the parameters, of course, your port for your outgoing mail server. And then, of course, you set up the other email recipients to receive the emails on those events that take place. And again, always test it before you actually put the system into full production. So you want to verify. In this case, you do have the ability to change. If I were to say all critical events, I do want to have email events, but I don't really going to need pop-up. So my main concern is being able to get system log to the DSS, have the DSS email, as well as provide the events, and also set up your email within the MegaRAID storage manager. So you can see that the individual events, if we look at it, there's a lot of descriptions. So a lot of them you just may not care for. Snapshot schedule is due, so you may not want to have that. You may want to disable that or completely take the MSM log for that as well. But as you can see, that could be time consuming. If you look at all these hundreds of different types of events, they may not be pertinent to you. Anyway, that's what we wanted to demonstrate today because we have a lot of people asking how do we prevent the events from DSS picking up on every type of information, but we only want certain ones coming from the critical and fatal. So that's pretty much what you want to do to set that up. Well, I hope this helps everybody. And if you have any questions, please email always us at the pre-sales@open-e.com. Thank you, everyone. Take care.